Public health spokesperson Janella Carrera says the letter that shouldn't have been sent was written by someone who was in an acting capacity and not vetted by upper management.
The acting human services program administrator was not aware of the facts as they developed. Had the right set of eyes gotten on that letter before it went out, then, you know, we would have been able to sit down and discuss the options or what developments were happening.
The letter advised that the foster care would no longer be covered by GovGuam's health insurance plan and would be replaced instead by Medicaid. That triggered a flurry of letters and concerned responses from the foster parent community to Vice Speaker Barnes and to the governor herself, all saying that the coverage must continue.
There's other services that they rely on, like mental health coverage and other types of coverage that the GovGuam health insurance provides for. And so it's very important, and we recognize that. And that's why, and as you, I think you saw the governor's response to the vice speaker and to Senator Torres, that it's unacceptable. And it's the same with us.
She says, to be clear, the funding is available and insurance coverage for foster care will continue uninterrupted.